So let's talk to a guy that actually knows about golf, plays golf every morning, and is a legend on top of that, the great Joe Beningo. Good morning, Joseph.
Sydney Arthur, first of all, Ride Like the Wind is better than Sailing by Christopher Cross.
Okay, I like that.
Number two, I don't know what was the bigger disgrace last night, the January 6th hearings or the Ranger game. I don't know, it was close.
It was close. Here you are, you're up to, and Joe and I are both diehard Ranger fans, if you didn't know that, going back many, many years ago to the days we worked together hosting middays at WFAN in the early 2000s. You're up 2-0, you got a 2-0 game on the on the road in game three, and you're well on your way to going up 3-0, and now I know they did it against Pittsburgh. I know they did it against Carolina. This team has won 2 straight Stanley Cups. It ain't going to happen. So very depressing way, I think, the season is about to end.
Yeah, no, I couldn't agree more. I'm very concerned. Look, you know what the problem is here, bro? And like you said, look, they won an elimination game in Pittsburgh. They won the 7th game in Carolina.
Well, they won 3 elimination games in Pittsburgh and 2 against Carolina, don't forget.
Well, they won, but in Pittsburgh, that game 6,
right,
only one
right.
of the elimination games was in Pittsburgh.
Right,
game
that's
6.
True. Right.
And the same thing with Game 7 in Carolina. Look, they're 5-0 in elimination games, but they're playing this. This is a dynasty freaking team they're playing. If they get to, they'll only be the second team. This is amazing to me. Only the second team in the history of hockey to go to 3 straight Stanley Cup finals. Only the Islanders that went to 5 in a row and from 80 to 84 have done that. That's amazing to me.
It is amazing. And, you know, you mentioned the Islanders, and, of course, everybody knows the names. Mike Bossy, Brian Trottier. Yep. They're all Hall of Famers. Potman, Billy Smith.
Yep.
You even know, Al Arbor. You know everybody, even in the front office. You'll be hard-pressed for any even rabid sports fan to say John Cooper. They think that's the guy that coached Ohio State in college football.
Right.
He's
right.
got to be the guy who's, like, the winningest coach ever who nobody knows.
Well, all these guys are Hall of Fame. I mean, Victor Hedman's going to the Hall of Fame. Stamkos, Nikita Kucherov. I mean, all these guys are all freaking Hall of Famers.
The goalie too, but they're not nearly as big.
Too, right?
But they're
That's
not nearly as
too.
Big in hockey lore as Mike Bossy or Dennis Potvin.
No. But they win 3 in a row. They've won 10 straight playoff series. I think only that Islander team had won more. Maybe there was another one. Maybe the Canadians too. But I mean, you know. Look, who knows? You never know. They're still alive, but you can't feel very good about Saturday night.
And I tell you, you're talking about Tampa Bay and John Cooper. They've now been in the finals 6 of the last 8 years. They're on the way to the 3rd straight Stanley Cup. They've been a dynasty, like you said. We got the same thing in the NBA. Same exact stat. 6 times in 8 years, like the Lightning.
Yep.
The Golden State Warriors have been in the NBA finals. But Steve Kerr, the coach, is such a jerk-off. I can't even appreciate it.
Please, I can't stand Steve. Don't get me started on Steve Kerr, you know? Hey, Steve, how about saying something about China? How about it, Steve? You have plenty to say about this country. You have plenty to say about Donald Trump when Big Don was the president. How about talking about China and the Uyghurs or when they closed down Shanghai? They wouldn't even let people out of their house about a month ago. How about you saying something about that? Nah, please. You know, as much as I hated the Celtics, the Bill Russell Celtics, and you know Dave Cowens and Hondo and all those guys,
Larry Bird Celtics,
and all of that.
Right.
As much as I hated them, I can't stand the Warriors. I hope the Celtics beat them, and I think they will. I think Boston's going to win.
No, they are going to win. They're the better defensive team. They're up 2-1. But I was having this conversation with Leslie Visser on the show a couple of days ago. I mean, Joe, I remember the days when you had to have 3 Hall of Famers, whether it was, you know, Bird, Parrish, McHale, Magic, Worthy, Kareem, whatever.
Right.
I mean, again, you'll be hard-pressed outside of Steph Curry. I know Tatum is a great young player. Jaylen Brown can play.
Right.
But you look at the names on these 2 rosters – it's hard to believe these are NBA Finals teams.
Well, Klay Thompson, I mean, these guys have won a lot.
Klay Thompson would have come off the bench for the Lakers.
The only reason I'm bringing him up is because these guys have won a lot of championships. Draymond Green, I can't stand the guy. But, he's won what, 3 championships?
He's a Dennis Rodman. He rebounds. He hits a shot once in a while. He's an instigator.
He is nowhere close.
No, I know, but I'm saying he's that type of player. Draymond Green is not going out there to score 40 points and win a game for you.
No. But don't insult Dennis Rodman, okay? Please.
You're right. All right, so we got the hockey and the basketball out of the way. The real reason why I had you on was to talk about golf. I'm going to take a very quick break. because we care about the clock on this show. I'll tell you, that's become number one, Joe.
It's very big deal.
We'll come back with the legendary Joe Beningo right after this. Joe, we talked about the hockey. We talked about the basketball. You love golf. You play all the time. You're actually pretty good at it. I don't really play. I turn down huge tournaments about three or four times this summer, but I do love to watch it. I'm up on it. And I, for one, am not happy that these guys took the money from Saudi Arabia, guys like Phil Mickelson, Dustin Johnson. Would I have done it? Yes. I'm the first to admit it. That doesn't mean they're not up for criticism. They took the money. The PGA is not easy to work with. I understand that. But that country, Saudi Arabia, what they do to women, what they do to gay people, 9/11, that is not the place to be taking money from. What are your thoughts on all these golfers defecting and taking money from Saudi Arabia?
First of all, I think you two is your all-time favorite group.
Yes, that's correct. That's right.
I just wanted to clarify that. Yeah. What do I think? I mean, look, first of all, there's a lot of the PGA. There's a lot of things about the PGA that get me aggravated. Okay, so we could go on with that. Look, we understand the kind of country Saudi Arabia is. But if somebody comes up to you, I mean, I understand, you know, whether you're Dustin Johnson, whether you're Phil Mickelson, whether you're Sergio Garcia, you know, whoever it may be, Taylor Gooch, okay, who also has gone there, Patrick Reed, whoever you want to talk about, you know, Graham McDowell. Somebody comes up to you in the case of DJ and says, here's $125 million. And I understand the guy's got plenty of money. We know that. All right. Phil Mickelson, here's $200 million to help your gambling habit. OK, whatever. All right. It's pretty hard to turn that money down, Sid. And I understand where it's coming from. I get it. But, you know, it's hard for me to say to these guys, don't take the money.
No, I agree.
And like you said, you do it too.
Of course.
It's hard to kill these guys about that.
Yeah, but here's the thing. You do things in life, and I've done many of them.
Right. You've done a couple. Let's not say many.
Yeah, by the way, so have you. But on a serious note.
I've done a couple, you've done many. That's the thing.
Yeah, you're right. But then you have to realize when you do it, yes, I would do it too. That's true. But when you do it, you are going to be criticized, maybe even taken to the woodshed. You got to live with that.
Right. No, I agree. But you know what? They're going to let these guys play in the U.S. Open next week, okay? Which they should. I mean, these guys, they should be in the U.S. Open.
Well, hold on. You know, it's not going to let them play. I don't believe the PGA Tour has any power with that tournament, right?
Right. No. Right. But they're playing. Right. They don't. You're right. But they're playing in that. And I think eventually the PGA is going to have to realize there's too many big names here for us to not let these guys continue to play in PGA tournaments. Because you're only talking about six or seven tournaments with this LIV, whatever they call this thing.
Yeah.
I don't even know what they call it. I think it's LIV.
It is LIV for the Roman numeral number 54.
And there's what that is?
Yes. Yes.
By the way, 54, I just want to mention, could I just say this? That this will be the 54th consecutive year that the Jets will not be in the Super Bowl. And can I say this, too? Remember when the Rangers, it took them 54 years from 1940 to win the Cup in 94.
Yeah.
And that was like, they used to chant 1940 and all that. Nobody cares that the Jets have been 54 years without a Super Bowl, right? Nobody gives a damn.
Nobody.
I just want to point that out.
No, you do. Joe Nolan does. I don't even think Joe Namath cares at this point. I think he likes it. I don't think he wants the team to ever win again.
Maybe not. Maybe
yeah.
he doesn't.
Yeah, because he's still the man. Hey, let me ask you, stick with golf for a second. The last time we saw Tiger, he was limping off the course on a Saturday after a brutal performance.
At the PGA.
Correct. And I know we had that improbable win a couple of years ago, and he was many, many years before that. He had won a major. Exactly. But now, after this latest car accident, coupled with the back and knee issues, do you think Tiger Woods, A, will continue to play much longer, and B, ever win a big tournament again?
You know what? That's a great question. You know what, Sid? You know, you go back to the Masters. He actually played pretty well the first two rounds of the Masters. And I think eventually it just catches up to him. You know, all the walking, I think that's what happened at the PGA as well. He eventually had to withdraw from the last round. He's not playing next week at the U.S. Open. He says he's going to play at St. Andrews in July in the Open Championship. The one thing I'll say, Sid, I would never count this guy out, okay? You want to say that Jack Nicklaus is the greatest golfer of all time, Tiger's the next guy, I don't know. It's pretty close. It's either him or the other one. It's either Jack or him. I would never count Tiger out. I'll say that.
I don't disagree with you, but I think it's close to counting him out, and I do believe he is second behind Nicklaus, not because he's won three less. It's 18-15, just based on consistency. It was like Don Mattingly. Mattingly was an amazing player, but, you know, he got hurt, and then he ended up with Kirby Puckett numbers. Anyway, which is not bad, by the way. Puckett's a Hall of Famer.
By the way, they put Kirby Puckett in the Hall of Fame, but not Mattingly, but we'll leave that alone
But that's because if you look at Puckett's yearly stats, they were pretty consistent, and
Why Puckett's in and Don Mattingly's not. He won two World Series with the Twins.
That's true, too. Right, true. 60 seconds to go, Joe, and you sound as good, if not better than ever, and I know the fan listeners miss you dearly. No knock at Brandon and Tiki. They're doing a very good job, but I know they miss you very, very much. Talk about the president, Joe Biden. He was on Jimmy Kimmel two nights ago.
Disgrace.
Robert De Niro last night.
How does he sleep at night?
I don't know. I think he sleeps fine.
This guy has sold the country down the river. Let's be honest. He's in bed with the Chinese government. There's no doubt, as are so many people there. I mean, it's an absolute... How does this guy look in the mirror? How does he live? It's unreal.
Well, how does he do it? You have people like Robert De Niro on with Colbert last night saying he's doing a terrific job.
Yeah, Robert De Niro's a joke. Who's he kidding to? Give me a break. Go do another C-class movie or something. Hollywood. What a joke they are, too. Unbelievable. You know, you're paying $5-something for gas. These guys, you know, they all complain, the ridiculous climate change hoax and all that nonsense. Don't get me started. I'm aggravated enough about the Ranger game.
I know. What time are you hitting the links today?
I think 12 o'clock.
Okay.
I got to do my podcast. I got to rip the ranges now doing my podcast.
How come you never invite me on the podcast?
Well, let's go. You want to come on Monday? You're a busy guy. I do it. When do you want to do it? You tell me when.
I want to come on Monday.
You want to come on Monday?
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to give you a call. I'll call you over the weekend. You're not working, right?
Nope. I'll be home. Call me over the weekend. I love you. This was a great appearance. As always, enjoy the golf. I'll talk to you over the weekend, okay?
All the love, bro.
The great Joe Beningo, coupled with the great Bono. 2 hours in the books. We are Bernie and Sid.